What's going on, everybody? Welcome to a new video. This one is going to be on three things that if you're not already doing in Madden and you start doing them today, they'll really separate you from the beginners and the casual players of the world, and you'll be beating them really with no problem at all. And so the first thing is using a linebacker or a safety. If you're not already using a linebacker or safety and you're using a defensive lineman, you need to learn how to use a linebacker. Just the amount of improvement it brings to your defense in terms of coverage and the amount of turnovers you'll be forcing is monumental. And be honest, you know, the beginners and casual players, a lot of times, and even people online who play a decent amount, you know, guys who play online, they tunnel and tunnel on one receiver only, and they're looking for the same guy over the middle of the field. And if you know that and you can sit on their main read or bait them into throwing it, make it look like it's open and take it away at the last second, you're going to be so much better on defense than if you were using a defensive lineman and there was nothing you could do about them hitting the same guy over the middle of the field over and over and over. So using a linebacker and taking away the primary guy your opponent wants to throw the football to is easily the biggest step that you can take in terms of Madden that will dramatically increase, you know, your level at the game and how good you are and how well you're able to compete against other players. So right there you saw Anthony Barr intercepting that pass over the middle of the field. In this case, this is what happens if you're using a defensive lineman. Same exact play on defense, same play on offense, and this time Barr goes with the drag and your opponent's able to hit that guy over the middle. Whereas if you were using Anthony Barr, you could bite down on the drag, fake like you're going for it, and cut back and take away that route over the middle. If your opponent adjusts and says, okay, he wants to take away the route over the middle, and so I'm going to start hitting the drag, you can act like you're going to cover the middle, bam, undercut the drag. And, you know, if you undercut a drag, usually it's a pick six, and you're going to be celebrating in the end zone. So, like I said, that is the easiest way to dramatically increase your skill level at the game of Madden, is learn how to use a linebacker or a safety in pass coverage. It will help you so much. Another thing you could do to really kind of take that step to separate yourself from a lot of your friends and, you know, more beginner or casual Madden players is don't call your plays by coach suggestions. You know, whether you're on offense or defense, you don't want to call your plays by coach suggestions. Really, there's a little bit of a rhyme and reason as to why the certain plays are presented to you, but at the end of the day, it's really just kind of like sticking your hand in a bag and grabbing whatever you feel first and pulling it out. Much more ideally, on offense and defense, you want to be able to call your plays by formation. You want to have a scheme and you know, kind of a plan of attack. And if you have a formation you're very comfortable with, then you can constantly kind of use that formation or a little group of formations. You don't want to branch out to stuff that you're unfamiliar with in the middle of a game a lot of the times. If you're not comfortable calling your plays by formation on offense, you know, still concepts are good. You know, you have the different running concepts. If you know, you notice that your opponent's aligning their defense more towards the middle, then you can see here a sweep might be a good call against that. Go to the outside. Vice versa, if they're all spread out, your opponent's calling a lot of, you know, wide defenses like dime and dollar, then maybe you go with something like an ISO. Same for defense. You really want to go by formation once again. But if you're not comfortable with formation, then run pass counters is actually a great way. As you can see, if I go ahead and pick a play, then you can go ahead and see which different things that you want to counter. So you can defend the run or defend the pass, and it even gives you and breaks down different categories of what kind of pass do you want to defend. Basically, you can say, dang, my opponent keeps hitting me short over the middle. Well, I want to defend short inside passes. These are good defenses to do that. Man, my opponent's, you know, really killing me with Ezekiel Elliott on the inside. I want to call one of these defenses to try and slow them down, whatever it might be. So that's really another step that you can take that will pretty much instantly elevate your game if you stop using coach suggestions and start actually calling your plays. The third and final tip, and it kind of really goes hand in hand with the last one, but find an offensive and defensive playbook that you like to use and stick with them no matter what team you use. Just because you use, you know, the Atlanta Falcons doesn't mean you have to use their playbook. If you want to use the Saints playbook and use the Falcons, then do that. It's probably more important on offense than defense. Defensively, if you're more of a beginner or casual player, you probably just want to figure out if you want to run a base 3-4 or a 4-3. So you want to use 3D linemen and 4 linebackers, or 4D linemen and 3 linebackers. Really, a 4-3 will probably give you a better pass rush. A 3-4 will give you, you know, more exotic blitz options and kind of a more diverse defense. So that kind of is the major decision you want to make on defense. But offensively, you know, it's very, very important to be in a formation and have passing plays, especially as a beginner player, to have these plays that you're comfortable with. So like I said, you know, if you play with the Saints and you love their pistol bunch tight end, well, pistol bunch tight end is a formation, you know, that's not in a lot of playbooks. So if you go ahead and, you know, you always call pistol bunch tight end, but then say one time you want to play with the Oakland Raiders and you pick their playbook, well, suddenly, you know, they don't have pistol bunch tight end and you have to call plays that you're not familiar with at all. And that's really the biggest hindrance, in my opinion, and whenever I watch like my friends or more casual players play, is that they just kind of call random plays and they don't really know their reads because they're not comfortable with it and they don't really stick with one thing that they know. They just kind of do random stuff, and that's probably the biggest step that you can take, is stop doing random stuff and actually have a plan of attack on the offensive side of the ball. But those are the three tips, in my opinion, that can really take your game from a very beginner standpoint to a competitive standpoint where you're ready to basically start beating up on all your friends and competing online. But that's going to do it for this video, guys. As always, thank you so much for watching. Until next time, take it easy.